Hi, my name is Vijay Durant. Thank you for coming for the talk. I'm going to talk about the Fresco Pulp Export Tool. If you have any questions, feel free to interrupt me on the way. The agenda for the day is as follows. I'm going to talk a little bit about the Pulp Export Tool, which is currently there, that Dennis Santos had created. The extensions are made to the tool, and then I do a small demo, and then I'll give you some details about the Pulp Export Tool here. Over the last year, for some reason or the other, I've been doing a bunch of migration projects from different systems into Alfresco. In all cases, I've been using the Pulp Import Tool by Peter Monks. I use the in-place import for that. There's also the out-of-the-box Pulp Import Tool in Alfresco, which I believe is an older version of Peter Monks' tool. There was one project where I had to export data out of an older version of Alfresco, that is 4.2x, into the newer 5.1 Alfresco. My first thought was I could use an ACB file, I can export it and then do an import, but as you all know, you cannot migrate between versions, it was pretty slow. And also, it was not compatible with the Pulp Import Tool, which I really wanted to work. Looking on GitHub, I found the Dennis Santos Alfresco Pulp Export Tool. That was pretty helpful for me to start with. The tool has no UI, it's just a simple web script call. All you have to do is pass in the following parameters. The node ref is the node ref of the folder you need to export. The base is the location on your file system where you want to export the files and the metadata to be exported out of. And the ignore exported is a flag. If you want to ignore the files that are already exported, you should set that to true. The export versions and the revision head both work together. So if you want to export all the versions inside of Fresco inside the folder, you can set that to true, and if the revision head is false, that means the last version will not be numbered. If it's true, the last version will be numbered. And the use node cache, I think that's a little misleading. It doesn't cache anything, it just gets a list of object IDs, or I mean node refs, that needs to be exported out of Alfresco, so that you can get a list, and then if new data is added to the folder, you don't get the new data, you get the old data first, and then you can use a last export to get the last bit of data outside. The UI is pretty straightforward. When you hit the URL, you get almost nothing. You just see the busy icon in the browser at the top. And once it's done, in this case, it took about 26 seconds to complete. You just see a simple export finished message. This was how it was initially. And there was no way for you to monitor how long it took or when it's what's happening from the UI itself. You had to go to the Fresco logs or Catalina log if you're using Tomcat. And for every 100 nodes, it logs a message. And this is the way you can know it's done. The logging information, this is pretty basic. It gives you an idea of what kind of default log levels I have set. The export class is the main controlling class. That calls the engine, which is the heart of the system. And the engine class orchestrates the whole export process using the file folder class and the Alfresco export DO import. The file folder class is responsible for writing the data out of Alfresco into the system and having it in the folder. The file system folder. And the Alfresco export import is used to talk to Alfresco all the methods related to that is in that class. I had to update the Pulp Export Tool for the following reason. The main reason I had updated was because The client was running an older version of Alfresco, which is 4.2x, and they were using an old server, which they couldn't add more CPU or RAM into, and that led for them to, and also there was a problem with the server, where they had to restart the server every day also to be useful. That I needed a way for the server, the export to take place when the users were not using it, and also without breaking it. I didn't want to restart the whole thing. So the updates look pretty straightforward. The only change is I added a new parameter called cancel in the web script, and you pass in a job ID that helps you to stop the job, and you can also stop the job. The UI, I have added a new UI, and you can access it directly using that URL. Without, if you don't use a parameter, you get the UI. The reason for adding, I've added these six new extensions to the tool. The first is the UI. I added the UI mainly to monitor the status of the export. I did not want to look at the logs every single time. And it was very easy for me to use, and if I wanted to add new functionality, I did not want to pass all the data into the web script through query parameters. The next one was jobs. I needed a way to start the job, stop the job, and restart it from where it started. I did not want to restart the job from the beginning. I needed a way to get the last mile of data, so I wanted to go at the end of my 1 month or whatever, however long it takes to export. The last week, if people modified some data, I just wanted to get that small bit of new modified data to replace it. So I needed a date range based option to export the data. And the next, add aspects and properties. So when I want to export data from an old system to a new system, I wanted to know which data was exported so that in the new system I would know this wasn't migrated data. So I wanted to a way to add aspects, like say a migrated aspect, and I want to have new properties into it. So the exported data itself will have these new values. And similarly, the updation of the existing types, aspects, and also the model prefix, you can update it if you have a new model in the new system. I'll get into more detail as I show the demo. The UI looks as follows. This is the new UI. The first section has the input parameters, and there's a initiate bulk export button, and once you click on it, the values in here will start updating. That's the way to monitor the data and export. The folder node ref, that's why you needed the node ref of the folder. There's a there's a tool tip over there for you to read in case you forgot. The next one is the output folder where you write the nodes and the children. The format is in the bulk import format. The from date and the to date, these two are the date-based export queries you can do, and it takes the date in the format of the ISO date format that offers you this. So you can inject custom aspects. Example is shown here. You can add my aspect test on my aspect template, whatever. You can also add properties, and you can update the existing model information change the model prefix too. This is the checkbox you use for if you don't want to re-export the existing already written exported files. The export version and the description head are pretty much the same boolean which I mentioned earlier in the URL. This node cache is pretty similar. It's just the object list of the nodes that you want to export from the folder. I have recorded the demonstration, split it into different pieces so that it's useful. and I also did not want to take chances in case demo goes wrong. So there are seven pieces of information I'm going to share. It's going to be really quick. The first one is without using the cache. It's a single pass export, and then there's a, when I use a cache, I do first get the list of nodes, fill the cache, and then I do an export. It uses the cache, the nodes in the cache to do the export. The next one is about the modify date. The last four is about the versions and about adding and updating the metadata files. Okay, so this is about the basic export. So all I need to do is I need to get the folder node draft. I need to get the base folder of the variable device. Before I start, I'm going to show you there are about 1,000 documents and about 50 folders in this folder. I'm showing this simple JavaScript. I'm grabbing the node ref from the folder, and I'm going to paste it, and I'm going to create a folder on my file system, and then starts the export. If I stop the export, then I can restart it. But since I'm not using any cache, it starts from the beginning. So it starts again from 1051. I've cut the clips. It takes about close to 2 minutes. Just for the sake of brevity, I've cut the clips. You can see the number of files and folders that are exported. So that's 1,000 files are exported, and the number of folders about 50. This is about using the cache. I'm going to export it into a new folder, and all I have to do is check that use node cache checkbox. So once the bulk export starts, currently the cache file has been written. It's pretty fast, it's less than a second. It found that there are 1,051 files. And if you look in the terminal, that will be a new cache file that was created. This contains a list of nodes. And you have to click the initiate bulk export again to do the actual export. Since this is a cached version, I can stop the export as it's going and then restart it. If you notice, 557 nodes are still there to be exported. And it creates a new complete file, which gets the list of exported nodes, 0.7. I'm clicking on the export, it starts from where it left off, so you're not the whole thing. Of course, as you notice, it's a bit slower. It took about 2 minutes 15 seconds because it's writing into the cache files. There's a lot of room for improvement of the performance. I'm just showing that there are about 50 folders and 1,000 documents. In this demo, I'm going to show exporting using dates. So I need to get the from date and to date. So to do that, I am modifying some folders inside of Fresco. The demo is, it adds on to the previous demo, so I'm going to run a small JavaScript to update the versions and also update the title of the documents. I'm not putting the start date and the end date in the ISO format. So you notice there are 174 documents that were touched. And I'm grabbing the start date, time, and then pasting it in the text box. And I'm going to update the folder. So, since the node cache is clicked, it just did the first pass, and you notice it's showing 174 nodes. That is the exact number of nodes we touched and modified. I'm clicking the bulk export again, and it's doing the export. And this time it took just 9 seconds. It has 174 documents that are exported in this. So this is where I'm exporting all the versions of the nodes. I'm changing the folder again, and then I have to check the export versions checkbox, and then I'm not going to check the revision head. What that means is the top level version will not be numbered. So, for example, if you have versions 1.0 and 1.1, and if that is not checked, then when you do a bulk import, then the 1.1 version will be imported as 2.0. So you see just the top level without the versioning, it should be 1.1. And the other one is version 1.0, that's the old version. So I'm going to check the revision head and just show you that it is exporting the 1.1 version also. In some cases, we don't really want to capture the same version from the older version. We keep the same version history. You can see there's version both 1.0 and 1.1. When you put this into a Fresco using bulk import, you would have versions 1.0 and 1.1 in the new system. All right, in this case, I'm going to add aspects to the exported data. I want to add a couple of aspects. One is the migration aspect to show which nodes were exported out and imported in the new system. And I'm also adding properties. You can have a constant value to the property as shown in the tooltip, or you can reference an existing property where I can reference the CM name to go into my new property, which is in the migration aspect. The new property is just my source ID. So if you look at the metadata file, you would notice the two aspects have been added over there. the my source ID is updated along with my sources to all that. In cases you want to update existing data, for example, if the new system has a new model prefix, you want to update that, or if you have the exact same property in the new system, then you would want to update, that is what being used in other cases, you want to update the model data also. So you can update the property, the aspects, and also the types. In this case, just for the sake of example, I have just mapping, I'm changing the CM title to source title, and then CM content type to my source type. The CM author has is both an aspect and also a property, and I'm changing the model prefix of sys to sources. Changes over there. Like all the sys have been changed to sources. So sources localized, and the type has been changed to source type.
Tell us a little bit about how much content you were able to export with this tool and how long it took to run.
I had to export about 1.5 million documents, and I had to do it over a period of a week, just running during non-business hours, and we shut down before 5 a.m. that time, and they had to restart the system. So it took me close to a week. But the performance on is highly dependent on how deep your folder structure is and how many nodes there are and those kind of basic.
So the link on top is where you have this shared with. I'm assuming everything you've done is open sourced. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Still can use it.
No, I just want to look at it.
Definitely. Yeah. So Dennis Santos, he created the initial tool. So I added to it, and I had to talk with him and make sure I do a pull request and add more.
Yeah, but all of this is leveraging the importer and the exporter objects inside of REST, right?
What do you mean, importer and exporter objects?
You, both you and the other project, you're using the importer and exporter objects inside of REST, so you're using the API to export it to import.
Yes, and I'm using the API, okay. Yes.
Yeah.
So I'm iterating through the folder structure and exporting it. Yes.
Can you, I'd be interested to know a little bit about your collaboration with the other people on this project, because just to give you an interesting story to hear about your collaboration with the other people on the project, because I know GS Denny started it, he worked with one customer, I know a few, you've been working with a different customer. Did you interact, and are you developing it together, or is it a fork at this point?
It is a fork. I did a fork, I started working on it. I did not collaborate. Most of the reason I updated this was because the client needed this export, and I had these issues. And when I talked to the people inside my company, they also had similar issues. So I just started working on it. But only after I was done and pushed it, I had a chat with Dennis, and we still need to iron out how to push it back.
So if somebody wanted to collaborate with you on this, what's the best way? GitHub pull request?
Yeah, definitely. Either do a pull request or email.
For sure. So when you do the export, are you exporting it to the regular bulk file system export with the XML, with that properties, that files and things like that?
Exactly. So I do it, the main reason I did this was because I want to use the, I want to leverage the bulk import tool and do the in-place import.
Okay, thanks.
Any other questions? Well, give him a nice round of applause. Thank you.